It's got to be one of these places. The arsonist's a bug sprayer. He must have worked at one of these joints.
Welcome back, everyone, to the final case of the game.
All right, you guys ready to wrap this up?
Oh, yes. Yes.
So where are we going?
We are looking for this arson suspect. We are looking for three places.
We're looking at three places.
Leland Monroe said he was a bug sprayer. So we're looking for three key places where they have bug sprayers. So,
the bug sprayers are us. Bug sprayers are bug sprayers emporium.
I was just hoping for
what?
I was hoping for the Play-Doh bug sprayer.
Ellie just got 500 points for grinding a 180 ollie.
Come on, Ellie, let's wrap this up with 5 stars.
I'm so screwed, like a
yeah, I wonder if Ellie can wrap up with a 5-star case.
I possibly
his bond. You won't even. Ellie, I think you could have 5-starred a lot more if you actually tried not to kill people.
At least one.
Did I before?
No.
I've got a 2-man, baby.
Womp, womp, womp.
Rapid exterminators. First stop.
Rapid.
Yeah. Place a bet, Elliot. You get a 5-star case. We'll think of something.
You get a 5-star case, we'll take you to a nightclub.
No.
Okay.
Help
Doesn't
you?
This look like Marquee Printing Company?
How many guys you have working here, Pop?
Who's asking, son?
It could be official or unofficial. Depends on how you want to play it.
You should get to a hospital, son. That arm of yours appears to be letting in daylight.
Save the pity for the other guys. They're the ones who need it. I'm looking for a big cowboy who works pest control. Does he work here?
We don't have anyone like that here.
You sure? I'm not the type of guy you want coming back.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Another paper?
Crusade against corruption. Peterson pledges to clean up LAPD. An assistant district attorney makes push for the top job city sorry state of advice squad as motivation.
Sight.
What have you got?
Looks like a drug overdose.
Get away from him, Phelps. This is my case.
Shut your fucking mouth. Since when does a bagman work a case?
I knew this creep wasn't on the morphine heist. Victim of his own product.
Hey, detective! Can we back it off a notch? This is getting out of hand.
A time to talk and a time to shut up. Now is a time to be quiet, son.
Courtney Sheldon was a corpsman, Roy. He served his country. He went out with a medical kit and an Army 45 into places that made the Valley of Death look like a picnic. He was either naive enough or dumb enough to get involved in the Suburban Redevelopment Fund, along with the mayor, the DA, Monroe, and a certain crooked cop. He was involved in the morphine heist, but he has a puncture wound in his jugular, which makes this a murder case. He was a better man than you'll ever know. You say one more word about him, and I will blow your fucking head off!
You finally lost it, partner.
I have a pretty good idea why Sheldon's dead. And I know about Monroe. Your vast, corrupt future is draining away as we speak.
I got better things to do than argue the rub with you.
Stay with him until the coroner gets here. Make sure technical services bags the evidence. If you let this creep anywhere near it, I'll come looking for you.
Yes, sir.
You know, Phelps, you're not the worst asshole going around.
Hey!
Now you see why.
I have the weirdest boner.
Need this? Oh, there's only one more newspaper. I think I know where that might be.
I do too.
But... Pest truck.
But too much is
next location, we are going to Nuclear Bug and Rodent Control. Fancy name.
Hopefully somewhere nearby.
Who knows, maybe this place will have that description that he gave.
Yep.
What the hell? There we go.
I'm starting to understand your hatred for the telephone
poles. Oh, man. Let's go to this place. You know, like, maybe this will have that description Jack gave. I don't know.
Jack Daniels?
No, Kelso.
Oh.
Jack Daniels is nowhere near here.
Oh, he's within us all at every pub on Saturday night.
I think you want
when he goes mixed.
Okay.
Smooth driving.
Nice.
Why can't you do that more often?
So you mean you were playing the idiot?
Like it was his game and he wanted to play it how he wanted to. Oh, you.
Tell me. That shouldn't count.
It's 2:59.
Do you know where your mother is?
Welcome to Nuclear. What can I do you for?
I work for the DA. I need to speak with an exterminator, big guy with a cowboy accent.
We have only three people work here, me and two Mexicans. They're both on the scrawny side.
Thanks for your help.
That was fast.
Yeah, right.
Do you know this man? No. Okay, I'm on here.
Do you know this man? Nope. Thanks.
Are you lying to me? Yes.
All right, Westlake Pest Control. Last one.
Elliot?
He ran into me.
That still counts against you, dude.
Look at that dent. Oof.
A little axle grease will get that right out.
Okay, since this is the last location, maybe he works there. Maybe.
Maybe he's freelance.
I think by the way of the game structure, it has to be.
That or he's freelance.
There's no other place in the book.
Wait, what do you mean freelance?
Works by himself.
Ah.
Self-employed.
Exactly. Think Johnny. Like and us.
Works at home, gets paid.
But not quite enough to go out and have fun.
Not yet.
Check core temperature.
Yes. Give me 5 years.
Yes.
Damn.
Shut up, John.
Sometimes though, you can't help but get the feeling like they swerve into you just to be jerks sometimes.
Oh.
Because I've had more than a few times where I had to restart a kiss because some assholes kept swerving into me.
Well, if it was Phelps driving, I would say it's a case of comeuppance, but it's Kelso.
What? Matt, that's L.A.
He hasn't had time to be nearly as destructive as Phelps. And there goes your five.
It was Cole Phelps' fault.
Fucking moron.
Keen! Kind of pooped in there.
Did I see Pepto-Bismol?
What?
Yeah.
No. I work for the DA. I'm looking for a big cowboy who does extermination. Anyone like that working here?
Well, I wouldn't want to get anyone into any trouble.
We could do this the hard way. An address?
Yeah. He lives in a bunkhouse on the remains of the old Rancho Rincon.
Thanks.
Cole, you made it.
What's this got to do with me, Rusty?
Dr. Fontaine, prominent shrink, dead in his patient's room. Spine snapped like a twig. The suspect is one of his mental patients.
I've met Fontaine.
His last patient was Elsa Lichtman, Cole. She's missing. Nurse said that she saw some big Boris Karloff type carry her out of here.
The best thing that you can do to help me, Rusty, is let me take a look around.
Sure thing, Cole. This way.
He is pretty much as tall as Frankenstein.
Yeah.
Well, I should say the creature.
Boris Karloff.
Boris Karloff is as tall as the creature. Because he is the creature.
Huh? That's what have we got here?
Irrelevant.
Whiskey.
No.
Don't think this is.
However, this is.
Hello, Army Morphine. Jesus. We haven't seen you since Vice.
Looks like Fontaine has finally dispensed his last treatment.
Magpie.
That's a goal too. Be proud.
What's that? What's the stipulation for that?
You find 95% of the clues throughout the game.
I'll give you and the doctor some privacy.
And I'm assuming 100% of the clues is another trophy.
So you just need 95 or better.
The face of progress says Mayor of Developer Leland Monroe.
Monroe.
Meh. Property tycoon has 10-year plan for City of Los Angeles. Monroe humbled by words of praise.
Complains of thigh injury.
That goddamn pet lunatic of yours is burning down our houses.
Keep your voice down, Leland. Control is of the essence.
Keep your voice down? Do you know how much these sons of bitches charge for lunch? Fuck up, Leland.
We will not solve our problems by announcing them to the general public. We only speed ourselves on our way to the gallows.
He's your imbecile, Harlan. Get him under control or get rid of him.
Speaking of which, I've had to dispose of our young medical student.
What?
Certainly are a cold character, Harlan.
He has a friend called Kelso who knows all about the development on Normandy Avenue.
I know about Kelso.
And you thought it unimportant to inform
me. I thought I could take care of it.
Have you?
No, I haven't.
Kelso works for Benson. Is he reliable?
No, he's totally unreliable. But he has so many pernicious habits, he's got nowhere to run.
Can you take care of Kelso?
Don't push me, Harlan. Get rid of the fruitcake. No longer necessary. I'll take care of you, Kelso.
Yeah, because he did a good job before.
That was before.
Oh, this is before the raid?
Because Harlan would be dead.
I know this is awfully morbid of me to say, but I was looking forward to this part.
IH. Oh, of course it works.
Fire. He must be the culprit.
We have our culprit, the liner.
Destroyed by a monster of your own creation, Dr. Fontaine.
Why does he have a black
heard
eye?
That story somewhere.
Probably knocked the fuck out.
I think it was called Blankenstein.
He's always wearing this red turtleneck sweater.
He doesn't wash.
Yeah, right.
I mean, did you see how much of a prick the Asian dry cleaner was?
So much for your foresight, Doctor.
That crystal ball was used to knock out Elsa.
Right on. The civil law were the properties you wanted accounted for me. My associate made a thorough survey. From what he tells me, I gather these facilities and residents are no longer required the assistance provided by a relocation process. All of these people.
Monroe wasn't happy. People started dying and it attracted attention. Then the doctor lost control.
Oh boy. What do we have here? Case of blank. Sharecroft farming family, found work as a stuntman, whatever. Died in 1945. Whoa! Scroll up. Nature disorder. We're referred to yourself from an acute case of battle fatigue. Shell shock.
Yeah.
He also seemed to be a huge arsonist.
He's the one that caused these fires, then.
Yeah.
Right.
Possible flamethrower duties back in the war.
Yeah.
The doctor has been marking this
Check
map.
This shit out. The freeway was going right... Remember the freeway from back in traffic?
Yeah.
It was going to go right through the Wilshire Division. So they built houses around that area. It turns out the scam isn't just Edward insurance Road. Fraud.
McCarthy Vista.
Are you familiar with the term eminent
Carson
domain?
Heights. Rancho Escondido. Do those names mean anything to you, Herschel?
Basically, as it was a government state, as it was a government funded project, the development fund was slated to build the houses there for cheap and then collect the money by means of eminent domain from the government. They would have made a flipping killing.
Freeway?
It's basically a con job on the government. And they would have been none the damn wiser. LAPD covers it up to make sure the government has no idea about it. The morphine is pretty much what she used to gather up revenue. The houses were to be burned down by means of a rogue arsonist so that they couldn't be caught, which is Fontaine's
insurance. It's about eminent domain.
What are you talking about, Cole?
The government reclaims the land in the path of the freeway and pays the improved value of the land with the new houses sitting on it.
What about the stiffs who paid their deposits?
Worst case, they get their money back. But the syndicate pockets millions on the improved value of the land.
So where does Jack's boss come into it?
He's the key. He carries the insurance. The insurance proves how much the houses are worth.
And they're worth nothing?
Firewood. All of them.
That's about as neat a scam as you can imagine. How are we going to prove any of this, Cole? The doctor's dead. Monroe nearly bled to death. If they get Jack...
We need the firebug. Yoki Cowboy. Get him, get Elsa. Get him, get all of them.
So that's basically their scam.
Wow.
Who needs to get the creature?
Exactly. Problem is that the arsonist went rogue. Yeah. So now, if the arsonist is constantly going out and burning things up, it looks really bad on everybody, especially the LAPD, since they're not covering for it, and then the government's going to wonder, what the hell are they doing?
Yeah.
Number one. Number two, if the arsonist in question, Mr. Blankety Blank, decides to testify against Harlan Fontaine, then you've got the whole thing exposed and blown out the water.
Wow. I like how Matthew's opening your perspective on this.
I don't know how to beat that.
No, he's giving you an explanation of what's going on.
Nobody's home.
Guess nobody's home.
His hand's still bleeding.
Yeah.
Bitch. Oh, boy.
Is that a flamethrower? Those guys bring home a 45 or an M1. This is pretty extreme.
What else does this guy have?
What was that? Cactus?
Tim.
Lighter foot.
Crawler kill.
Crawler kill. Most likely flammable.
Insecticides are always usually flammable stuff.
Fowler.
This guy's place is a shit off.
It's all on me.
They would later reuse this as the setting for Texas Chainsaw Massacre.
The next generation?
No. The original in 73.
Ah, okay.
What, 70 something?
Why not? This place looks like it's...
No, it was 73.
It was 73?
Yeah, because it came out before Halloween.
Yeah, this place looks like it's definitely over budget.
The origamis.
Scott Shelby.
It's definitely Scott Shelby.
Spoilers to Heavy Rain. We assume...
Yeah, you watched this, Play?
I've already watched Heavy Rain LP. If not...
go check it out.
Sorry.
Go check it out.
Here's my
chainsaw guy in the nuts.
Quite a flock.
Here's what I think. I think Scott Shelby died from old age at this. And then he believed in reincarnation and reincarnated into a pedophile cop.
No, but good idea. The LA River.
The river tunnels. This guy's a tunnel rat.
Basically, he gets away through the LA tunnels.
Yep.
That's gonna be more than this.
Showers.
Mosquito coil. Son of a bitch.
His left arm filmed.
Probably rotted away at this point.
But he's still using it.
Flyer.
Another one.
Why the origami again?
Must have been in the war.
Exactly. That's probably why he keeps making him. He keeps flicking back to that. Wait a minute.
I know those faces. Jesus Christ, I know every one of them.
They're us, Kelso.
Oh my God, Ira. You poor backwards son of a bitch.
And that's our arsonist, Ira Hodgeboom.
Peterson, I'm going to need some help. I've got Monroe, Fontaine, and all the others. It's all tied up nicely. It goes all the way to the top. Meet me at the LA River Tunnel entrance just north of the First Street Bridge in half an hour. Don't ask questions. Just be there. This is DA's investigator Jack Kelso. I have an urgent radio message for Detective Cole Phelps.
KGPL.
11K, see the man. A 207 just occurred on the spillway north of the First Street Bridge. DA's investigator Jack Kelso reports a kidnapping suspect outstanding in the LA River tunnel system with a hostage. 11K, handle code 3.
What the hell is Jack playing at? Like a suicide note. Half the LAPD will be down there hunting for us.
We need to get there first.
All units on all frequencies stand by. Car 86 Adam is in pursuit of suspect vehicle heading southwest on Sunset Boulevard. Suspect vehicle belonging to Jack Kelso, described as a Navy Chevrolet Fleet Line. License number 4, William 0286. Car 86 Adam is in pursuit.
I picked up his car. I'll need help to make it to the river.
Blah, blah. Ball America.
Love America.
That's Kelso's car.
Oh, here we go.
Alright, Elliot, I'm trusting you here. Finish this off with a smile.
Smiles, people! You want it to be a, like, Jeff the Killer smile or Joker smile?
A regular happy smile, Elliot.
There goes one. Heyo!
So, are you trying to camouflage your way? Like, making it look like you're chasing after him, or...?
No, I'm helping him.
Are they well aware that you're
against
the LAPD?
Yes, they know now.
How many cops are these guys own?
Hey, they're talking about us! Shut up, Phelps. They'll just have to follow the trail of destruction, Elliot.
Yeah, it's like, leave them off. It feels odd being on the other side of the spectrum now.
Got it?
Damn it!
I can't turn that fast.
And they're still shooting at me!
The cars don't last very long, though.
Attaboy, Kelso. See, he's learned.
I taught you well.
Yes.
Stop, suck him.
Both of psycho manner.
Shit.
Just back up.
You still got time. Yeah, see. Rubber band AI?
I don't understand.
Seems like you long shook them off.
If you're playing too good, the AI will kick your ass. But if you're playing stupidly, the AI will be just as stupid.
We're almost there.
Hey, look, it's a shortcut.
Exactly.
Hi.
Who is this guy? Totally Peterson, awesome. Assistant DA.
What's he
He's
doing?
He's here to cover our backs.
I'm going in there, Jack.
No one's trying to stop you. I found this at the ranch house. He's marked his routes. I'll go in here. Cole, you take the next entrance. Biggs, I need you to take the car and cover this spot here. I think that's his failsafe exit. Cole, he's one of ours.
Right where you are!
Got it. Peterson, you want to be DA? We'll earn your salt.
So, Kelso is your boy, Peterson? And working with Phelps? The handy lad, that Kelso.
Yes, he is, Chief. You can't imagine what those two have uncovered. It could go all the way to the top. I hope you won't be implicated.
So, you're the new groom, Peterson?
Looks like it.
And you think he'll make it out of there alive?
I think he might. He's a difficult boy to get rid of.
All right, Peterson. I'm listening. What's your offer?
Well, this is it. That's part of the game. What the hell?
Good thing you're looking smart than anyone.
Yeah, alright. Good thing I'm back in color, otherwise this would be painful.
You gonna pick up a shotgun? The line?
Come on. Right ahead. This is definitely much more action-packed than the last one.
He has a distinguished army run.
He's trained. Elliot isn't, but Jack is trained.
Yeah, I think we know that, Matt.
Oh, every time I see him run like that, I think of Forrest Gump.
There he is.
Maybe it won't hurt so bad.
He just sat into the water.
Lubba dub dub.
Going up. There's another one. Got him.
You are too, sir.
You're dismissed. Pretty dead for a dead man.
Here you get a flamethrower, and it's really not worth using.
Wait, not yet, not yet. See, you ruined it, Matt.
Oh. Sorry.
I think the flamethrower is useful.
In fact, I think for LP's sake, we should shut off. Couldn't really do anything with it on Resident Evil, so let's make up for it. Throw out the gun.
Got him.
I'm gonna assume none of these guys have army experience.
No.
Ooh.
Ooh. I gotta find Ira quick. That's one. That's another. There goes the other. And another.
Like ducks at a shooting range.
Damn.
My hat!
What's up?
I'm trying to find the way down.
Are you on a time limit?
Go straight. No.
How long do you think you can hold out?
Oh. There you go.
Will that start flooding you if you take too long?
No. At least not yet.
That's good to be running ammo, that thing. Not yet.
Now I'm out.
I'm about to take one of their weapons.
Come on.
Well, they're not gonna use them.
Ooh.
Is that
one more hit? One more hit. Got him. And now we use a flamethrower.
Now I know what it feels like to be a Ghostbuster. Timing.
The water's right.
See that?
It looks bad here.
Flowing water is actually pretty hard to render.
Yeah.
Like, if it's a still body of ocean water, that's pretty easy. But if it's constantly flowing, I don't think...
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure technology can do it nowadays. But, if you want to run it in real time, no, that's a different issue in itself.
We're almost there.
Can the PS3 run Crysis?
Yeah.
Yeah. Why?
I was just curious.
Oh, man. Oof.
Jesus.
Fire!
I don't want to be them.
Does this have ammo?
Yeah. Why, the flamethrower sucks. Exhibit A.
Cover, Ellie, cover, cover.
I'm trying!
It's like, oh, I'm just gonna pretend you didn't do that.
Oh.
That's your form of cover, Ellie. Hug the wall.
Did he say that, or did Kelso say that?
Somebody else said it.
The guy that got shot?
Dead end. Moving on. Oh, shit.
Can you jump over there?
No.
Can't jump over there?
No.
Well, with the flamethrower attached to your back, I understand that, but...
Are you okay, Princess?
I felt better. He saved me from the doctor.
I'm not sure that I'd do if you come here to kill her.
Why would I do that, soldier?
Isn't that why you're all here?
I'm here to get her out.
But not me. You haven't come for me.
No, not you. It ends here.
You were winning sixth on Sugarloaf, weren't you?
I was.
And Nahal?
Yes, I was.
You're Sergeant Jack Kelso, aren't you? Where's your uniform, Sarge?
At home in my locker, Hogaboom! War's over, soldier!
I know that, Sarge. I'm fighting a different kind of war. I fight for God now.
We all fight for God, Ira.
In our own ways. Not everyone knows it.
Elsa! Are you all right? Get away from her!
It's all right, Cole. He doesn't want to hurt her. Ira was with us on Okinawa.
What? You know this guy?
Don't you remember me, Lieutenant? I remember you.
No. No.
You ordered me to burn that cave, Lieutenant. That cave full of civilians. A hospital.
What is he talking about?
It was war. For God's sake, I can't be held responsible for everything that happened.
I don't blame you, Lieutenant. You helped me to help other people.
Ira lost his mind on Okinawa, Princess.
Sheldon asked the doctor to help him get back.
The doctor helped me to find my path. And I helped him to a better life.
Elsa's going to leave now, Ira. She will be all right. You've helped her, too. Get her out of here. Biggs will help. His exit is nearby.
Jack, I need this guy to make the case.
Hasn't this poor bastard given you enough? Get out of here now!
For God's sake, Jack! What are you going to do?
Don't cry, Miss. Sergeant Kelso has come to help ease my way. I was proud to serve with you, Jack.
Get out of here, Cole!
Jesus, look at all the kids!
Stop the goddamn screaming!
I need to think!
And how do you expect to do that, you fucking maniac? They're burned to a crisp!
Finish them off. Do it humanely. We are leaving this place.
You do it, Phelps! Get your own fucking hands dirty! I'm out of morphine!
Put these people out of their pain. Now! That's an order!
Everyone out of here now. Double time! You two get Lieutenant Phelps to an aid station. Weapon team will be blowing this place in 2 minutes. Everything that happened in here stays in here. Do you hear me? I don't want to ever hear another word about
gathered here to honor Detective Cole Phelps. Cole Phelps was the best kind of man.
Hear, hear.
A war hero who led his men with true valor. and through his personal bravery achieved one of his country's highest honors. A cop wrongly accused who never lost his faith in the LAPD and the system.
God, you belittle his memory.
Elsa.
Out of my way, Jack. You call yourself his friend.
A detective who fought to expose the evil corruption of the murderous Dr. Fontaine and the rapacious property tycoon, Leland Monroe.
Go to her. Will you, Herschel?
A reformer who recognized the need to remove the odd bad apple from a department made up of good men.
Herschel?
A man who never gave up.
Yeah, Jack.
Who continued to fight the good fight.
I think you knew that, Jack.
The fight that cost him his own life. A good husband. A good father. And may I say, a good friend.
By the way, that happens to be Peterson. Peterson actually took the cop out, and so he secured the DA position while becoming embroiled in the conspiracy himself. So basically, everybody got away with it, and the Suburban Redevelopment Fund is mostly dead, so that's stopped, but they're dead, Cole's dead, and corruption goes on.
Ain't that the truth, though?
Amen. Meanwhile, they earned a trophy.
And it abruptly ends.
Well, you're dead.
Yeah, Phelps is dead.
Yeah, but like, I'd like to see a little bit more, you know?
Well,
like,
granted, you kind of want to see where Kelso goes on from this point.
Exactly.
Kelso just wants to get the fuck out of Dodge while he still can. Frankly, Kelso's covered under, what's his name's protection, since he now works for Peterson.
Yeah, so he's fine anyway, as long as Peterson's still there.
Right.
So, yeah, that's all you know. Noir.
I hear that, I'm not sure if this was cancer or anything like that, but I hear they were actually going to continue LA Noir through a television series.
I know nothing of it.
I think it was just called Noir.
I heard about that, but they had to change the... It's not a continuation.
You're thinking of a different kind of story. I know what you're talking about. You read that article on Kotaku too, did you?
Yeah.
That's a different series.
Oh.
Manga? I heard they were going to continue this game's story through a television series.
Well,
I had never heard of that either.
I heard of it, but I haven't heard much of it, so I'm just going to assume it's canned silently.
Yeah.
I would like to see it, because, again, I agree, because... This is abrupt. You know, it's not.
Bandai probably went nuts. Remember, there was a lot of strife at the back end of this game too.
True.
Yeah, I know.
No, seriously, like I said it way back in Patrol that McNamara was working him to death. I wasn't exaggerating.
No, yeah, I wasn't. I would never assume you are, Matt. I'm just saying that because of all of that, this game suffered.
Yeah.
In terms of a story.
Right.
In two major areas. One,
the love affair.
The love affair. Yeah. Which really comes out of fucking nowhere.
I saw some dude on TV Tropes who claims he explained it all away. I was like, half of this shit is implied, half of this shit has no ground, and the third half of your two-halves theorem is completely fucking wrong. Like, I read the dude, he's like, yeah, it makes sense. It comes out of nowhere only if you weren't paying attention. I was like, dude, you made connections nobody else fucking did. Because there are no fucking connections. It's exactly as you said, bro. It came out of fucking left field.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And secondly, it's the abrupt ending.
Yes.
You know, in the end, the
it fits the noir storytelling angle, though. Just
very
not
true.
Not very much of a satisfying.
And noir stories often end in downer endings.
Yeah.
Right. But I think there's a difference between downer and abrupt is what you're getting at.
Because of its abruptness, it's a downer ending.
Right.
But...
Yeah.
Well, if that's the case, then you're fine. Then you're fine. Me, I only beat this game by once through, twice over when I had to go back through for an extra case. And while I'll admit it ain't necessarily Game of the Year material, I enjoyed the ride while I had it. Earned my platinum in it.
Well, going just to get from an LP's perspective, I really did enjoy this LP. You know, I wasn't expecting it to be this long, but I did enjoy my run through as the newbie here watching this stuff. And I really did like
Cole Phelps was
pretty much. We gave Phelps so many jobs.
Including death. How do you do that job?
Yeah.
Alright, well, final thoughts?
Elliot,
you first. You play it again.
Well, I honestly didn't know what I was really getting my hands into when I first bought this game.
Did you buy it on a whim, or did you...
I bought it because, like, I saw trailers for it, and I thought it looked really good. It looked like one of Rockstar's best-looking games.
Well, it's not Rockstar.
I know, but still. But I beat... This is my fifth time beating this game. I played this game so many times. I love the story. I love its graphics. I love the interrogation scenes where you had to, like, think about whether they're lying or not. The reason they had to do these kind of animations is because they can't really program whether someone's lying or not. That would be way too much.
Well, no, they can program emotions because it's not a matter.
You're supposed to judge it by their facial expressions. That's the mocap technology in this game.
They can animate it, but the thing is, though. Animating emotions.
It wasn't animated. They used mocap to capture the face technology.
I'm telling the reason why they decided to go with. It's not just mocap though. It's a more advanced kind of mocap.
Yeah, I know. That's what I'm saying.
But it's not because they couldn't. It's because it takes too fucking long.
Yeah.
That's why they went with this new beta like technology.
Motion scan.
They're obviously good to use for later titles.
Right.
It's a huge sandbox game, but they got it down packed to what a 1940s LA would look like. It looks like the 1940s. It feels like the 1940s. It actually works perfectly.
Oh, the research is
intensive. And
damn, it's central.
And yeah, like during your journey, you find historical landmarks. That's something I really like. I like how like they would take historical landmarks and put it into the game so that you might be able to know what they are.
You like the detail.
I love the attention to detail. Yeah. They put so much detail into it. It's literally one of the best games that they published. And the soundtrack, I can't help but love this soundtrack. The soundtrack, it's jazzy, it's noir. That's what I love about it. Like I literally managed to get the soundtrack and I listened to the entire thing and I love it. It works so well with it, and Andy Hain, I think is his name, did a great job with this soundtrack.
Okay. Matt?
I thoroughly enjoyed the story. I enjoyed the story up until the end of Advice, because right when that angle came into play, I was like, how the fuck this happened? And then Arson, despite being a little more interesting than I thought it would be, ultimately was just sort of amounting to the paperwork and the whole downer ending. I did enjoy the atmosphere most of all. It captured the 1940s perfectly with the amount of research they did, and it shows. The cars handled a bit like ass in comparison to what I thought they should, but 1940s cars, I can make an exception to that. I thought the achievements were very fair and reasonable. I thought the music was actually really good and well-spoken for its time as well. As I agree with Elliot, Andy Hayes did a great job. Unfortunately for me, unlike Elliot, LA Noire wasn't necessarily a game I really went back to most of the time. Interestingly enough, once I'd done the Platinum, or rather when I beat the game, I was surprised I really went back for the DLC, to be honest. But then I figured, hell with it, they're easy golds, I'll go after them too. So, basically, I can say I enjoyed LA Noire, but...
Would you recommend it?
Yeah, I would recommend it, don't get me wrong. But, like I said, I wouldn't necessarily call this game of the year material by any stretch of the imagination.
I would like to say one more thing. The partners that you have throughout your adventure, very memorable. Almost every character that you run into, all of them are memorable.
Anything's focused on the plot anyway. Yeah.
Well,
Andrew Hale, that's the name.
Memorable, but one note. One's burned out, one's an asshole, one's an alcoholic, and then there's Bukowski, who's awesome.
Bukowski is awesome. Well, John?
No, actually, I like Biggs. I like Biggs, too.
I like Biggs the most.
Yeah.
Well, John, what about you?
All right, well, I'm still rather much of the newbie here. I mean, ever since after around the middle of Homicide, I actually picked up the game myself on Steam, which you can get for about $15 at now. It's the complete version. You get everything, including the DLC. And I started playing the game. I stopped it around the beginning of Homicide because I didn't want to go over Elliot in terms of the LP. But I've had better times with Grand Theft Auto, we'll say that. But Noir is meant to be enjoyed from not only a story perspective, but an artistic perspective.
Yeah, you're supposed to be a cop this time.
You're supposed to get... They want you to get immersed in this game's atmosphere. You know, 1940s Los Angeles. And that could be quite an adventure. I mean, despite how long this LP has gone, Elliot hasn't even explored half of Los Angeles in terms of the map. Because there's so many things you can do besides getting the golden film reels, which, what do those do?
Nothing.
They're nothing for achievement.
Just for trophies?
Yep.
There is a silver, though, but and it makes you explore the town more intricately than you normally think you would.
There's the hidden cars, there's the street crimes that Elliot didn't showcase, but we're not going to because they have no meaning on the plot whatsoever. You know, and...
Don't want to make it longer than
I enjoyed what I played. It is rather slow-paced, though.
That's what it's supposed to do.
Well, because they want to... Again, like I was... That's adding further credence to my... immersion angle. But if you are of the Grand Theft Auto type, this may not satisfy your needs.
It won't.
How about this for a headline? Guess which former 6th Marine hero has been promoted in the LAPD?
No idea.
Well, could be anybody.
You give up?
Tell us or hand over the fucking paper.
The Shadow Boys, our very own Silver Star winning son of a bitch.
Phelps? He didn't die, Jack.
He did just fine, and that's all we're going to say about it, right?
The one and only. Look at this picture. Golden Boy getting his badge, wife and kids in tow, and looking awful humble in the process.
Well, he's set.
Phony bastard.
I wonder if they've been holding my job for me after all this time.
What job was that?
Mechanic.
Ain't you seen all the war bond movies, Sarge? All the best mechanics is women. You're gonna have to work as a gigolo from here on in.
I was a bus driver in Santa Cruz. No pictures in the papers or medals for me, though.
I can't believe I just went through Petaluma and Okinawa just to go back to being a washing machine mechanic.
How is it that jerks like Phelps get it all?
It doesn't have to be that way, guys.
What are you talking about? It's always gonna be that way.
Do you have any idea what you guys are sitting on?
Yeah, a ship full of army surplus.
You're sitting on surplus morphine. 2 tons of it. Can you imagine what that's worth on the streets? Hundreds of thousands of dollars.
You're shitting me.
I'm not.
You're talking about stealing it?
Keep your voice down. Do you want to have us all thrown in the brig?
God damn it, Sheldon. You want to go into the dope business?
No. I want to be in the peace dividend business.
What is that supposed to mean?
It means I want the guys who fought for a better future to get some share of it. You interested, Jack?
Come on, Top. We could all get out from under.
Oh, it's the chance of our lives.
It's everyone or no one, boys.
I'm not having a bar of it, Courtney. You may be the bravest person I have ever met, but I swear to God, trouble follows you around like a pet fucking dog. I thought you wanted to try for medical school.
So what do you want, Jack? What's the future got in store for you?
You guys were all heroes in the war. Every single one of you. Even if your next door neighbor or your wife never know it and don't give a rat's ass. Fuck Phelps and medals and citations and parades. Fuck the public who are bored with returning GIs. I have nothing but respect for what you guys and the rest of the 6th have done. You go through with this, and you'll be nothing to me.
So now we see a little bit of the origin of the SS Coolridge heist.
And fuck you, Sheldon.
Like,
it's kind of an odd time to show that.
Yeah. But this is definitely for those that like to get into the detective motive or someone who's just into noir, mainly.
Like, I do love a good noir story.
I think noir for this game, I think this game is just perfect for noir. It fits the tone.
I don't know. Like I said, because of Elsa and the whole left field of it, it felt like they were starting to lose the plot of noir and went general cop story. So they threw in the Elsa angle, and it just did it for the sake of being noir, making it feel rather contrived noir rather than pure and genuine noir, you know?
I would like to say, though, I wish they would add a little bit more to the game. Like
DLC.
Story-wise,
or...
in general, because when you finish a desk, you have the streets of L.A.
It's frame room.
Yes. Yeah. It would be nice, to go bowling or see a movie or something. You know, it would be a little nice to see
that. To be more like Grand Theft Auto.
A little bit, but still showing that it's still not in that Grand Theft Auto way.
Can just bowl for pedestrians.
You want Grand Theft Auto 1940s edition.
No, I seriously...
He wants to go sneak dancing at the old sock hop.
I seriously wasn't expecting this to be 1940s GTA. But I didn't expect it to be like this, but I loved it.
regardless.
Regardless, no matter what it is, I still love it. It's still one of those good games that I would sometimes pick up. Sometimes pick up, yes. I said that.
But it's a good kind of sort of, not bad, sometimes great, good sort of.
It's still
indecisive,
great,
mixed bag kind of good, perfect
it's,
game.
It's still a great game because I get questions wrong.
You enjoyed it. Mac got some jollies out of it. I liked what I played, but this is not something I would go back and revisit.
Yeah.
But I did enjoy this LP with you guys. With that said, let's lay off the big games for a little bit. I think the last big game we're going to be doing for now is Legends, which is already currently underway.
Yes.
But Elliot, you want to tell the guys next time you are meeting in the LP universe with game you're playing?
Next game I will play will be Sly Cooper and the Thievius Raccoonus.
For the, is that the first game?
First one, for the PlayStation 2. Yes, I'm playing the Sly PS2
Cooper.
Version.
Sly Cooper. It's about proper time, right?
I'll be the newbie in that one. I have no idea about that.
I never played Sly Cooper either.
You guys might like it.
Well, maybe I'll go out of my way and play so I'm not a complete newbie. I don't mind being the newbie, but I like to be in the bag too.
Yeah.
But, okay. So, with all that said, ladies and gentlemen, I'm Johnny.
I'm Elliot.
I'm Tyre.
We're the Super Gamer Brothers. You guys have a great night. Thank you for watching, and take care.
Oh, yeah, by the way, watch out in the streets. You might find Troll Phelps hitting you. You don't know.
Monroe.